Hello, welcome to our test shop at Saws UK. This is our E300 mitring bandsaw. You can use it in the pull down mode or the hydraulic mode. That means that it comes down under its own weight through a hydraulic cylinder. This lever here applies tension to the bow so that you can actually pull the machine down by hand to do small cuts. Here we have a motor that's 2 horsepower driving a worm gearbox. Here we have the guide system, which is carbide tips, both sides of the blades at both ends. And behind that we have steel roller bearings, either side of the blade, each end. Okay, mitring on this machine. There are 2 latchable stops at the back of the machine. These are for the zero position and 45 degrees right and 45 degrees left for easy setting purposes. Additionally to that, there is a mitre scale here for all the angles in between. I'll just demonstrate the mitring on here. Unclamp the mitre here. I can unclamp the vise here to slide the vise around. I'll move the machine over here, demonstrating mitring, in this case to 45 degrees to the right. Now I'll mitre 45 degrees to the left, as an example. And I can slide the vise across to here, locking the vise, and also locking the mitring here. Right, main controls of the machine and adjustments. Here we have the tension lever and the pressure gauge. Pressure gauge has 3 zones, yellow, green and red. At the top of the green here is the optimum tension. Here we have the vise, of course, hand wheel, fast movement of vise, saves a lot of winding, and repetition. Just a small amount of movement here for repetitive cuts. The main isolator for the machine, emergency stop button, on and off controls, mode switch. This way it's for manual pull down mode, this way it's for hydraulic downfeed mode. 2-speed switch, fast for mild steel, aluminium, etc., slow for stainless steel, tall steel, etc. And a switch here for the coolant. You may wish to turn that off for certain materials like cast iron, for instance. Down here we have another emergency stop button and the controls for the downfeed. We can actually turn the downfeed completely off or on here and regulate the downfeed control here. Here we have a measuring stop that's graduated. This side is a small support roller. If you wish, we do 3 metre input roller track and 3 metre output roller track with a measuring system on it, on our options list. I'll now do some cuts. First of all, I'll do the manual cuts. Using the trigger switch here. Hydraulic downfeed. Just release this spring here. We can then open up this valve, allowing the machine to come down. Turn the mode switch to hydraulic. Start the blade here. Regulate the downfeed with this knob. Switches off at the end of the cut. I'm just lifting it up a little way. Turn the valve off. Move the work through. Clamp. Start.